Hey guys, today we're making a miniature Easter basket with Easter goodies. So you want to start out by taking some craft glue. I'm using tacky. And you just want to take whatever rope you might have. I'm using natural polished hemp. So you kind of just want to make a spiral. So just carry it around as far as you want it to be so that it ends up being the width of the basket, the bottom of the basket. So once you get to the desired width, you just want to let it start to dry just a little bit. And then once it has, you can add another ring of your glue and then take some more of your rope and just carry it around. Keep in mind that each time you take it around, you're going to need to add another layer of the glue to keep it held together. And don't worry, usually this type of glue, if you're using tacky or clear, it dries on clear. It looks a little messy in the beginning, but it dries clear, so everything will be perfectly fine once your basket completely dries. Now you can take another piece of rope and you want to kind of measure it out the height that you want your basket handle to be, and then just glue on the ends. And while your basket is drying, you can make little cute treats for the inside of your basket. I'm starting out with a chocolate bunny, so I'm using some chocolate clay to do that. You can use a lighter brown if you like, but I like the look of the chocolate. So just use your dotting tool to etch out the shape of the bunny and then kind of cut it out as close to the design you made. Next up, I'm just using a silicone tool to clean up the edges and make it look a little bit more professional and polished. And then I'm going to take a dotting tool again and then just kind of mark out the designs on the actual surface of the bunny. And you should have something kind of like this. Next, I'm taking some pastel colors and I rolled out a lot of snakes of them. And I'm going to use these to make the eggs. The chocolate color is going to be chocolate eggs, but I'm going to put a gold foil coating on it. So just take each piece and roll out a small little ball, and then kind of make it into an oval, like an egg shape. And then you can go ahead and set these aside to bake. Once you have as many eggs as you want, you can go ahead and pre-bake all of those and your bunnies. I made two bunnies, by the way, because one is going to be in gold foil as well. So now I'm just going to take the chocolate eggs and I'm going to roll them into some liquid Fimo tackle gel. And you can use TLS if you like, but I prefer the clearness of the Fimo. And now I'm just rolling these in some gold pigment powders, Pearl-X. And they should come out looking something like that. You can skip this step if you don't want any gold foil bunnies or eggs. Now that your basket is completely dry, you can fill your basket with some cotton. Just dab a little glue at the bottom and kind of press that in so your basket looks more full. And I cut up some green jute twine for the grass filling in the basket. And I also glued that down as well. So you should have something that looks kind of like this. Now you have all of your eggs and golden eggs possibly. Make sure that you go ahead and glaze those now so you don't have to do that later. And then put out some more of your craft glue. And you just want to take the bunny and dip the bottom of it into the glue and place it into the basket in whatever spot you want. You can take creative liberties when decorating the inside of your basket with the treats. You don't exactly have to do yours like mine, but I wanted my bunny to be the centerpiece. So just go ahead and dab each egg into the craft glue and then just place it anywhere in the basket you want it to be. And once you've done all that, you're done. Thank you for watching.